हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल सी मोमेंटम। ओके, सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन मस्ट अराइज इन योर माइंड इज व्हाई दिस क्वांटिटी इज नीडेड। ओके, व्हाई दिस मोमेंटम इज नीडेड। सो हियर लेट्स टेक टू एग्जांपल्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द इफेक्ट ऑफ मोमेंटम। फर्स्ट एग्जांपल नंबर वन, इफ अ वन लाइट स्मॉल स्टोन इज ड्रॉप फ्रॉम सम height on a glass pan which is placed on a horizontal table, we can say glass pan does not break. Why? Because the small is stone is too small, or you can say light in weight. But from the same height, okay, if the one heavier stone is dropped, what happens? In that case the glass pan will break. Why? What is the difference between two? Here the difference is what? Mass of the two stones. Okay, here the velocity of the both these stones will remains same, because we can say both are dropped from the same height. As both are dropped from the same height, so here I can say the velocity v square is equal to what? 2gh, and v is equal to 100√2gh. So velocity of both these stones is same because they are dropped from the same height, but the mass is different. So heavier stone will able to break the glass pan, while the lighter one does not able to break that. So here let's take another example, a second example. Okay, in this example let us take that bullet is fired from a gun. Okay, so we can say the greater retarding force is required to stop that bullet, because it is fired from a gun, it must have a large velocity. But if the bullet of same mass, okay, which is thrown from the hand, okay, it is we can say easier to stop that bullet, because it is thrown from a hand, it has a very less velocity. So retarding force required to stop such bullet is less. Okay, so here we can say both this bullet has the same mass, okay, but the former bullet which is fired from the gun has a large velocity. As it has a large velocity, so greater retarding force is required to stop that bullet. Okay, so here in this two example we can say to understand the effect of motion, mass and velocity, when both are combined, okay, it is very important. So we can say momentum of a body, a new quantity is defined, okay, which shows the combined effect of mass and velocity of the body. Okay, so here let's take the definition of momentum. What is momentum? Momentum is denoted by P. So here I can say momentum of a body is defined as product of mass and velocity of a body. Okay, it is denoted by P. Here if any body of mass m moving with velocity v, then its momentum p is defined as according to this definition, product of mass and velocity. So P is equal to mass, okay, and its velocity. Momentum is what? Product of mass and velocity, denoted by P, mass m, and here the velocity of body is V. Here you guys have to remember that velocity is a vector quantity, while the mass is scalar. So here momentum is also vector quantity. Okay, it is also vector quantity. Here I can say, here mass m is scalar, while velocity v is a vector. So here I can say momentum is वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, इसलिए मोमेंटम भी क्या है, वेक्टर क्वांटिटी है. ठीक है, चलो अब यहाँ पे मोमेंटम वेक्टर क्वांटिटी है तो उसकी डायरेक्शन बच्चों कहाँ पे होगी. सो ये राइट हैंड से एंड इट्स डायरेक्शन अब देख सकते हो मोमेंटम की डायरेक्शन ऑलवेज कहाँ पे होगी, वेलोसिटी वेक्टर की डायरेक्शन में भी होगी. So here we can say momentum vector is lies along a velocity vector. So its direction is always along direction of velocity. Okay, now let's say it's unit. We know that mass is measured in what, kg. Okay, unit of velocity is what, meter per second, or you can say meter second minus one. So unit of momentum is what, kg meter second minus one. Here I can say its unit is kg meter second minus one. Okay, अब जिस इसका यूनिट मिल गया है, ठीक है, तो हमने डायमेंशंस वैसे ऑलरेडी चैप्टर नंबर टू में निकाल लिए है, तो इसके डायमेंशंस क्या होंगे. डायमेंशंस आर वी कैन से एम वन फॉर के जी, एल वन फॉर मीटर एंड टी माइनस वन फॉर सेकेंड माइनस वन. सो हियर आई कैन से डायमेंशंस आर एम वन, एल वन, टी माइनस वन. Okay, so it is the momentum which can ask in a exam for 2 marks. Now this one is momentum, let us understand the change in momentum, what happens when momentum is changed. Okay, how the momentum of body will change. Okay, so for it here we will take one example. Okay, suppose a stone is rotated in a horizontal plane, okay, by means of a string. So here we can say, as the stone is rotated here with a uniform speed, here the stone is rotated with uniform speed, okay, in a horizontal plane by means of what, string. So its motion is what, uniform circular motion, as we know that it is rotated with uniform speed. So its motion is called what, uniform circular motion. So here we can say its speed is constant. Okay, as its speed is constant means we can say magnitude of velocity is constant, because speed is what, magnitude of velocity. Its mass is also remains constant while this motion, uniform circular motion. So here we can say magnitude of its momentum is also constant, but we know that in a uniform circular motion what happens, the direction of velocity is continuously changes and it is always along what, tangent. Direction of velocity at any point in a uniform circular motion is always along what, tangent drawn at that point. So here we can say, as direction of momentum is along the velocity vector, so we can say its momentum is also changes over here. Okay, because its direction is changes, its magnitude is constant. Once again, you have to remember that speed is constant, so magnitude of velocity is constant, and hence we can say magnitude of momentum is also constant. But the velocity vector is changes, its direction is changes, hence we can say direction of momentum is also changes. So overall, ultimately we can say the momentum is changes because its direction is changes. So here, as the stone is rotated, okay, we can say we have to apply a greater force. We have to apply what? A greater force, okay, to rotate that stone at a large speed. Or in the other word, we can say if the stone is rotated with a large speed, okay, then force applied, okay, by our hand, okay, by our hand must be greater. आपको ज्यादा स्पीड से रोटेट करवाना है तो आपको ज्यादा फोर्स एक्सर्ट करना पड़ेगा, ठीक है. सो उसका मोमेंटम भी क्या होगा, फास्टर रेट से चेंज हो रहा होगा. किसकी वजह से? आपने फोर्स अप्लाई किया उसकी वजह से. सो ओवरऑल आई कैन से द ग्रेटर इज द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम, द ग्रेटर इज द अप्लाइड फोर्स. अगर आपको मोमेंटम और भी ज़्यादा चेंज करवाना है, मतलब जितना फास्ट रोटेट करेगा उस इतना ज़्यादा उसका मोमेंटम वेक्टर जो होगा उतनी ज़्यादा चेंज हो रहा होगा विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम. ओके, सो हियर वी कैन से इट्स मोमेंटम इज चेंजेस विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम ड्यू टू व्हाट, ड्यू टू द अप्लाइड फोर्स. ओके, सो फ्रॉम इट वी हैव अ न्यूटन सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन विच सेज दैट रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम, टाइम रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ momentum is directly proportional to what? Applied force. This example, from this example we can say that the time rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to what? Applied force. And direction of that change in momentum, okay, would appear in the direction of applied force.